Hey y'all, welcome to Chaz's Lifestyle. I am Chef Chaz and I will be showing you all how to create savory and tender beef short ribs. I'm starting off with my beef short ribs. They are clean and fresh. I'm going to pour some olive oil on there and mix that in. Now this is going to help your seasoning stick. I'm just going to sprinkle with a little bit of kosher salt and then go in with a little bit of fresh black pepper. And then we're going to use some brown Jamaican seasoning. This is going to help give it that pretty brown color. We're going to marinate this for about an hour. If you can, overnight is better. Now in a preheated, I would say cast iron I recommend, but you can use just a regular skillet. I'm going to add in some of my bacon grease. If you don't have that, you can use olive oil. And I'm going to sear my beef short ribs for about 3 to 4 minutes on each side. You just want to braise them basically, so it's giving them a pretty color on each side. So after about 3 minutes, I am going to flip it. I have my heat on a medium heat, which is about 6. I'm making my beef short ribs in the Instant Pot. When I tell you I love my Instant Pot, every setting is awesome, especially the pressure cooker setting. Like, I haven't used my crockpot in about a year now. I will have more. I will have more recipes with the pressure cooker, the Instant Pot, air fryer. If you want more recipes as well, make sure you comment below your ideas. Short ribs are done. I'm going to take them out of my pan. Now we're going to keep that bacon grease, all those flavors. You see that? You want to keep that. So here I'm adding my green seasoning. If you don't have the ingredients for the green seasoning recipe, I do have 2 videos on that as well. You can just use 1 yellow onion chopped, and also if you like, you can use 1 green bell pepper chopped. And you can caramelize that in the cast iron until it's a little brown. Now this is, I'm doing the same process. My green seasoning is just vegetables, onions, garlic, a little bit of seasonings, and so forth. Now here I'm adding in about 2 tablespoons of unsalted butter. You can mix that in. You want it to melt very well. We're gonna go ahead and make our sauce. Now, after about 3 minutes, I'm going to add in my flour in increments. You don't want to add it all at once. So we're just going to mix that up. And I added in about 2 tablespoons of olive oil after this. You want to cook your flour for a good 3 to 4 minutes, constantly stirring. Then after that, you want to slowly pour in your beef broth. Pour it in slowly. As you all know, I will have all my ingredients listed down below in the description box, so be sure to check that out. Like I said, if you don't have the green seasoning mix, you can just use a couple seasonings and vegetables that I also will have listed down below, so that's an alternative. Now as you can see, I got that perfect consistency. If you want it more of a soupy base, then go ahead and add more beef broth. Here I'm adding in some red wine, low sodium soy sauce, Worcestershire sauce, and some sazon, of course, for the color, and more browning seasoning and my chicken bouillon. Now you can just flavor it up, use your own seasonings, add what you want. You can add your own all-purpose seasoning, you can add a little bit of Cajun seasoning in there, add some barbecue for a little sweetness, you can add honey for sweetness, about 1 tablespoon I would say, if you want more of a sweet savory flavor. And I was going for the same way I like my oxtails. I love my oxtails just smothered, you feel me? Here I'm adding in my short ribs and my sauce to my Instant Pot. This recipe is so easy and simple, y'all. Uh, So I have my pressure cooker set on high for about an hour, and I have it on keep warm. I'm going to close my valve. Then, as you can see, look at this. Oh my gosh, y'all. Of course, falling off the bone. Be careful. You want to keep it on the bone a little bit. But yes, falling off the bone, tender good. If you enjoyed this super quick and easy recipe, make sure you leave me a like, subscribe, join the family, and comment down below your favorite part. Also, let me know if there's any other recipes you'd like to see. If you recreate any of Chaz's recipes, be sure to tag me on Instagram at Chaz's Cuisine Story.